Hey friends, how you all doing? I am gonna make myself some lunch. I figured you might be interested. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to cut up some bacon. So that fits in my pan. Pan's already hot, obviously. And loud. Quiet that down a little bit. And I have here an egg, tomato, some onion, I'm gonna go ahead and cut a little off that onion. Take off the outer leaf. Maybe I'll take this one too. Put this remainder of the onion back in the fridge where it belongs. And let's go ahead and turn this bacon. It's already pretty puffed up. I have this on pretty high heat just to move it along. I'm going to further chop down this onion so it's just bits. Here is the pita. I really just kind of gave it a late bake so that it's not stiff out of the fridge. Take another look at our bacon. Oh, it's looking pretty good. One of the things I really love to do is get the bacon fat going and then scramble up an egg. And then just drop it in there and watch it sort of puff up with the fat. So I'm going to go back over here for a second. There's my egg. I'm going to take some of this freeze-dried basil, which I'm in love with. And a sufficient amount of pepper. Nice healthy pinch of salt. this one more time. Yeah, this is doing pretty good. This is some nice double thick cut bacon. I'm gonna take that egg and just make it a little scramble. Bacon is telling me it's all done. I'm going to go ahead and turn that way down to about 3. There, that's better. Alright, so I'm going to take that off and take this bacon, let it rest. Nice and crispy. I'm going to take the onion that I sliced, scrape it up just a little bit, drop that into the bacon fat. With all that heat, it's not going to take very long. It's also going to give a nice flavor to the bacon fat, nice over note. I'm going to take some of those bacon bits on the bottom and scrape them into the onion. Also make sure that my cast iron pan, which is my favorite pan by a long mile, make sure that it gets some of that hot oil so that it builds up its patina, or rather keeps its patina. Yeah. Good stuff. Real good stuff. I have this nice slotted spoon. I'm going to go ahead and take these onion bits and drop them into the egg. There it is. Okay. going to take my tiny whip, make sure that the onion gets worked all the way through. And then I'm going to gently drop the egg and onion mixture into the hot fat, which I've turned down. And I'm going to take the extra egg and put it to the outer edges. The egg really practically floats. Wow, it's hot. The egg practically floats in the oil, almost like a deep fried egg. You can see it's not offering a lot of resistance. I'm gonna let that puff up some more. Definitely not going on the cover of Architectural Digest, I can tell you that. But it's going to be pretty damn tasty. Add a little pinch of salt. A little bit of pepper. Now I'm going to retrieve and place the egg. Go ahead and turn that off. I happen to have here a official Kroger four cheese blend slice. I love these. I'm gonna go ahead and put that on there, let it melt. And I'm gonna take my knife and wash it. And dry it. And see if we can get some nice thin slices. Despite it being a very meaty potato, it doesn't have a lot, or tomato, it doesn't have a lot of flavor, unfortunately. This being the time of year when everything is dying. But I'm still grateful to have tomatoes. So, let's take a closer look. There's our bacon, egg, and cheese with tomato pita. And I cannot wait to sink my teeth into it. I appreciate you hanging out this long. I hope that you enjoyed watching me make my lunch. And I hope you have a great day. May you have peace. Love y'all.